NBC News World Headquarters in New York. This is NBC Nightly News with Lester Holt.
And some sobering numbers out tonight about veterans of the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan. The Associated Press reports they are filing for disability benefits at a historic rate, 45%, seeking compensation for their injuries. Which brings us to a fascinating look at how some of the wounded are getting cutting-edge help and a new lease on life. NBC's chief science correspondent Robert Bazell has that story.
Army Sergeant Ramon Padilla fought with the 173rd Airborne Brigade Combat Team in Afghanistan. The unit profiled in the award-winning war documentary, Restrepo. He was struck by a rocket in 2007.
Right away, I knew that I had lost my arm, and the only thing I was hoping for or praying for is that, you know, telling God that, you know, please let me see my wife and my kids one more time.
He was reunited with his family.
It offers up to 14 different ways to close an OP.
To replace lost arms, prosthetic specialist Ryan Spill and the researchers at Advanced Arm Dynamics.
This is called a power grip.
So this can be controlled by electrodes in the arm.
Yeah, this
are developing customized bionic hands, giving upper extremity amputees like Sergeant Padilla even more dexterity.
3 months later, I was playing catch, skiing, you know, golfing, and doing a bunch of other stuff.
When you're rock climbing, how long are you typically in the prosthesis?
Probably 6 to 8 hours.
Clinicians here work with each patient to meet their specific needs and interests.
This one is more of like a survival arm.
Triathlete Bernie Diamond lost his hand in a drive-by shooting and helped design this personalized prosthetic with built-in compass, Swiss Army knife,
with a bottle opener on it,
flint, flashlight.
It has this really cool light on here.
Even an iPod.
The standard of care 25 years ago was a mechanical hook. Now with some of the new electronic hands, we have all sorts of different grasp patterns, and the amount of effort that a patient uses to be able to operate that type of hand is much less.
Getting ever closer to the natural arm, lost by so many wounded warriors like Padilla.
So how's the speed of this compared to the Greifer?
And tens of thousands of others every year. Robert Bazell, NBC News, Philadelphia.
When we come back, we're going to...